Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector. Recently, we have made a detailed video where we have highlighted that Mazagaon Dock Shipbuilders have reported to parliamentary committees on defense that its much of infrastructure is going to be idle and waiting for fresh orders after the completion of Kalvari class submarines in 2024. At present, few more Kalvari class submarines are yet to be delivered out of 6. These are INS Vela, INS Vagir and INS Bakshir. INS Vela and INS Vagir are undergoing sea trials and the last vessel, INS Bakshir, is under construction, which means Mazagaon Dock Shipbuilders are building just one submarine at present, whereas they are capable of simultaneously constructing 11 submarines at various stages and can immediately undertake the construction of 7 more submarines. Now, the good news is that Indian Navy has decided to place the order for 6 more conventional submarines and could be very soon issue tender worth 50,000 crore. For this tender, the local and strategic partners have been identified and cleared by Indian Navy. They are Mazagaon Dock Limited MDL and Larsen & Toubro. They can tie up with 5 other global manufacturers including French Naval Group, German TKMS, South Korean Dow, Spanish Navantia and Russian Rosoborbo Export. The Defense Ministry is expected to discuss the project in detail on Friday. The high-level meeting would be discussing the project and it is scheduled to take up the draft request for proposal for clearance, after which the tender can be issued to the strategic partners. Under the Project 75, India has been building the Kalvari class diesel attack submarines based on the Scorpion class submarine designed by French Naval Defense and Energy Company DCNS and are being manufactured by Mazagaon Dock Limited in Mumbai. The new 6 conventional attack submarines will be the successor of the Scorpion or Kalvari class submarines, and it is expected that they will be integrated with air independent propulsion system, which is at present not there in any Indian submarines. The air independent propulsion or AIP technology reduces the dependency of diesel attack submarines on surface air. AIP is an electrolytic fuel cell that releases energy by combining hydrogen and oxygen with only water as the waste product. These cells are highly efficient and do not have moving parts, which ensures a low acoustic signature of submarines. DRDO has already developed this technology of AIP system, and the Kalvari class submarines will be also retrofitted with it during their midlife upgrade. Now, if we look into the requirements stated by Indian Navy for the 6 new conventional submarines, Navy wants the submarines to be equipped with heavy duty firepower. The submarines are expected to have 12 land attack cruise missile LSCM along with anti-ship cruise missile ASCM. The Navy has already specified that the submarine should also be able to carry and launch 18 heavyweight torpedoes in the sea. The firepower of the 6 new diesel attack submarine is going to be much more than the Scorpion class submarine, which also have heavyweight torpedoes and Exocet surface-to-surface missiles as their main weapons. Indian Navy is looking to acquire 24 new submarines, including 6 new nuclear attack submarines, to bolster its underwater fighting capabilities. At present, Indian Navy operates 15 conventional submarines, including 3 new Kalvari class submarines. India also has INS Chakra, leased from Russia, which is a nuclear attack submarine, and INS Arihant, a nuclear ballistic missile submarine. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.